Hi, I'm Daniel Chan from UNSW Australia. In this video, we'll be looking at some linear algebra and the question of finding bases. So the question that we'll look at today involves this 4x5 matrix A, and it asks us to show that the columns of the matrix A below do not span R4, and then to find a basis for R4 which contains as many of the columns of A as possible. Now, before we start doing this question, there are just some things that we should note. So the first thing is that even though there are two parts to this question, you can actually do both of them with one computation, just one Gaussian elimination. So don't do two separate Gaussian eliminations. That will save some time. And the other thing to note is roughly how we're going to approach this question. And the basic idea is as follows. So firstly, we're going to omit some of the columns of A to find a basis for the column space of A. So remember, what's the column space of A? It's just the span of the columns of A. And from there, it will be fairly easy to see that the columns of A do not, in fact, span R4. So once we have a basis for the column space of A, we'll need to throw in some extra vectors, some standard basis vectors, to actually extend that basis for the column space to an actual basis for R4 itself. Okay, so how do we do that in practice? What we're going to do is we're going to augment this matrix A as follows. We're going to augment it with the identity matrix I, and the reason for this is that the columns of the identity matrix I are just the standard basis vectors for R4. Okay, so in this example here, how does that work out? Okay, so let's just look explicitly. We add in the first column of I, which is E1, the first standard basis vector for R4, so that's 1, 0, 0, 0. Then we add in E2, 0, 1, 0, 0. Then we add in E3, 0, 0, 1, 0. Then we add in E4, 0, 0, 0, 1. And as you can see, you have the identity matrix here. And now what you want to do is you want to perform Gaussian elimination on the whole of this augmented matrix, which also includes the calculation which performs the Gaussian elimination just for this left-hand matrix, which is A. Okay, so let's go ahead and do that. So the first row, of course, stays is, that's fine. 1, 3, 3, minus 7, 5, 1, 0, 0, 0. We need to clear this entry here, so we double the first row, and we subtract that from the second row. Two ones are 2, so that gives us 0. Two threes are 6, so that also makes the second entry 0 here. Two threes are 6, from 5 leave minus 1. Twice minus 7 is negative 14, so subtracting negative 14, we get 14 minus 8, which is 6. Twice 5 is 10, so we get minus 9 here. Twice 1 is 2, so we get minus 2 here. And here we're just doubling zeros, so that doesn't affect the rest of this row. We have 1, 0, 0. 1, 0, 0. Okay, we need to clear this term in the third row here, so we need to triple the first row and subtract from here. That will give us a 0 here. Tripling 3 gives 9, which is the same as this, so that's also 0. Tripling 3 is 9. From 5 gives you minus 4. Tripling minus 7 gives you negative 21. So 21 minus 3 is 18. Tripling 5 is 15. So minus 2 minus 15 is minus 17. Tripling 1 gives you 3, so you get minus 3 here. And again, the rest of row is unaffected, so you get 0, 1, 0. And finally, for the fourth row, to clear this term here, we need to multiply the first row by 4 and subtract from here. That gives you 0. 4 threes are 12, gives you another 0. 4 threes are 12. 5 minus 12 gives you minus 7. 4 times negative 7 is negative 28. So subtracting that from 2 gives you 30. 4 times 5 is 20. So minus 5 minus 20 is negative 25. And four ones are four, so you've got minus four here. And again, the rest of the row is the same as the original. 0, 0, 1. Okay, so it's still not in row echelon form. So we need to clear these two terms. So we continue our Gaussian elimination. The first and the second row are fine, so let's just repeat them. 1, 3, 3, minus 7, 5, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, minus 1, 6, minus 9, minus 1, 6, minus 9, minus 2, 1, minus 2, 1, and then 0, 0. And now we have to do some work with the third and the fourth row. We need to clear this term. So we need to multiply the second row by 4 and subtract from here. That will give you a 0 there as well. Two zeros stay the same, of course. And you get a 0 here as well. 4 times 6 is 24. 18 minus 24 gives you minus 6. 4 times negative 9 is negative 36. So when you subtract negative 36 from 17, 36 minus 17, 19. 4 times negative 2 is negative 8. Subtracting negative 8 gives you 8 minus 3, which is 5. 4 times 1 is 4, so you get a negative 4 here. And then the two zeros here, multiplying them by 4, gives you 0 still, so it leaves the rest of this unaffected. 1, 0. That's the third row. For the fourth row, we need to clear this term. So we multiply the second row by 7 and subtract from here to make this 0 as well. So we'd have three zeros. 0, 0, 0. 7 times 6 is 42. 30 minus 42 is negative 12. 7 times negative 9 is negative 63. When you subtract negative 63 from negative 25, 63 minus 25 is 38. 7 times negative 2 is negative 14. From minus 4, 14 minus 4 is 10. 7 times 1 gives you 7, so you get a minus 7 here. And then the other last two entries are the same since you have zeros here. So that's 0 and 1. Okay, are we in row echelon form yet? We're still not in row echelon form. We need to clear this term as well. So one more go. So we keep the first three rows. 1, 3, 3, minus 7, 5, 1, 0, 0, 0. 0, 0, minus 1, 6, minus 9, minus 2, 1, 0, 0. 0, 0, 0, minus 6, 19, 5, minus 4, 1, 0. And to clear this term, we need to double the third row and subtract it from the fourth. 0, 0, 0. We've cleared this term to get you 0. Twice 19 is 38, so that gives you a 0 here. Twice 5 is 10, so you also get a 0 here. Twice minus 4 is negative 8. Subtracting negative 8 gives you a 1 here. 2 times 1 is 2, so that's minus 2. And this stays the same because of the 0 here. And now we see that finally we're in row echelon form. The leading entries are the ones here, the 1 here, minus 1 here, minus 6, and the 1. And as you can see, as you go down the rows, these leading entries move strictly to the right. So you definitely are in row echelon form. So that's the end of the calculation. And the question now is, how can we use this calculation to answer the two parts of this question? So the first part of the question is to show that the columns of the matrix do not span R4. So we also have here the Gaussian elimination for A. So the row reduced form for A It's just the left-hand matrix here. And what we see is that we have 1, 2, 3 leading columns in this row-reduced form. And so the dimension of the column space is 3. So we see now what is the column space of A. The column space of A, denoted as such, at least we know that the dimension of this is given by the number of leading columns in the row echelon form for A. There are 3 of them, so this is equal to 3. And of course, this is not the dimension of R4. So what we can conclude from that is that the column space of A cannot be R4. And remember, the column space of A is just the span of the columns of A. So that means that we've answered the first part of the question and shown that the columns of the matrix A do not span R4. Let's write that down. Hence, the columns of A don't span R4. Well, what about the second part of this question? So we can say a little bit more about the column space of A. We can actually give a basis for it. And the basis corresponds to these leading columns here. The first column, the third column, and the fourth column. What we do is we look back at the original matrix for A, the first, the third, and the fourth column, and they will give a basis for the column space of A. So you can omit the non-leading columns, the second one and the fifth one, and that gives you your basis, which is insufficient to span R4. And what we do now is we realize that to span R4, we need to add the vector corresponding to this leading column here. So that's the second standard basis vector here. So a basis for R4, which contains as many columns of A as possible, is, of course, it has to have 4 vectors. It has the 3 vectors correspond to the first, third, and fourth columns of the row echelon form. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, the first column of A, the third column of A, 3, 5, 5, 5, the fourth column of A, minus 7, minus 8, minus 3, 2. And finally, we have to add in one more vector from here, and that's this second standard basis vector, which corresponds to this leading column here. 0, 1, 0, 0. That completes this.